first time I took an Air Canada flight, I remember because it was a flight I took to get my interview to join Air Canada 7 years ago. So I remember vividly that flight from Santiago, Chile. People were treating me extremely well. It was a great experience.
At Air Canada, we're a global international airline. We're one of the top 15 largest airlines of the world. In a country of 40 million people, which is very sparsely populated, we have a three-hub strategy, Toronto being our number one hub, Vancouver being number two, and Montreal being number three. Given the amazing geography that we have here in Canada, basically almost every single flight that leaves out of Mexico, US, overflies Canadian airspace. We needed an airplane that can deal with a smaller population, but that can also travel significant distances. So range was a very critical element. The A220 is one of the best aircraft in this particular segment to do it. It enables us to grow our footprint here in North America and makes our international route network stronger.
We have embarked on that fleet renewal for some years now, and the 220 is the cornerstone of our narrow-body fleet renewal. It's the most versatile aircraft we've got today that can operate both on a very short haul market, from 1 hour, up to 6 hour flight. And the ability for us to fly between Montreal and Seattle, Montreal and San Diego, California, for example, that aircraft unlocked the opportunities. Without the 220 in our fleet, it would have simply been, you know, impossible to do it in a profitable way.
Right, 245, call your localized established to the left.
I flew last year between Dallas to Montreal, which is a 4 hour flight, and I was with our pilots looking at the flight plan, and I see that we only boarded 7 tons of fuel in this airplane. It just speaks to the amazing fuel efficiency of the airplane.
We used to fly bigger aircraft with more seats in a non-profitable way. When you get the A220 with our configuration at 137 seats, you have an aircraft that's the perfect size.
Our customers absolutely love the airplane. When we go into American markets, previously they were operated by a regional jet, which was smaller, or less customer friendly. On a 220, you get that wide body feeling, spacious, lots of light. And I think one of the biggest elements to that is the windows. The windows are big and brings a lot of light in. It's one of the best narrow body passenger experiences out there, bar none.
We didn't choose to have a premium cabin available. When you introduce the A220 in those markets, even on short haul, having the ability to offer a proper business class for those corporate customers or those like premium leisure customers going into a long trip connecting via one of our hubs, it's something that today we can monetize. And we feel that people are really willing to experience the business class and they will repeat again and again because they will really enjoy their time and they will want that again for the next trip. And I think that's really it for us, the versatility of the aircraft and the ability to operate in a very economical way and where the comfort of our passengers is one of the best. They love the A220 and it's always ranked with the highest NPS, Net Promoter Score, of our narrow-body fleet.
Since we made the initial acquisition order for 45 aircraft, we've committed to 65 aircraft. So that speaks to the confidence we have in the airplane, but also the relationship that we have with Airbus.
Every day, we're discovering new things that we want to do. We're thinking about new routes, new connectivity that we want to build for our customers. It's a fantastic job. It's a very exciting journey, and it's going to last, you know, for the next few years.